Hey everybody, this is Dan Reeser from Acala. Currently VP of Growth here. I've been on Acala team for a couple months and previously spent my time at Web3 Foundation where I helped launch Polkadot and Kusama. Today I'm going to make this really quick. I may talk fast because I'm trying to keep it in hopefully like 5 to 7 minutes, but I'm going to be talking about Polkadot and Kusama, parachain auctions and crowd loans, which are the process for how to launch a blockchain on one of these networks. So Polkadot and Kusama, as you may know, are these multi-chain ecosystems that are tying together a bunch of blockchains that are called parachains. In the future, there will be up to 100 parachains on Polkadot and 100 plus on Kusama. But as of now, there's no parachains on either one. So today I'm going to talk about how to actually earn a slot as one of these little squares here in this diagram. How do you actually become the first parachain on Kusama or the first parachain on Polkadot? And that process is crowd loans and parachain auctions. So this is the timeline. You can see here that crowd loans come first, which I'll get into. The main event is the parachain auction here in white. This is multiple parachain teams essentially bidding against each other, trying to win this auction. The winner of the auction then moves on and earns a slot here in the green. Once you earn a slot, then you're officially on Kusama or on Polkadot as a parachain team, and you can begin launching your applications. Applications can build on you and so on. And this is ultimately the vision of Polkadot and Kusama. And then the last part here, you can see there's an actual end time of this slot that the team earns. So after the team earns that slot, then there's things that happen, including crowd loan funds being returned to the contributors and so on. And I'll cover all that in the next few slides. So parachain auctions I'm going to start with because you need to understand this before we go into crowd loans. So a parachain slot auction is essentially, like I said, teams bidding against each other to try to win one of these slots. Each auction is ultimately going for one slot. It can be divided into smaller chunks, but ultimately on Polkadot, it can be up to 24 months, but some teams may decide to bid for shorter. But to keep this simple, let's just assume the maximum. And teams that are going into this auction have two options for how to actually bid and what funds to use for their bid. So first is if you have a single account, say for Kusama, you have a stack of KSM that you want to use for this auction and you don't need to involve your community, then that could be one option. The more frequent and more likely scenario will be number two here, which is using the crowd loan module. So in this case, you're actually crowdsourcing KSM in the case of Kusama, or crowdsourcing DOT from your community, and you're basically crowdsourcing this so that you can use that in the parachain slot auction. How often will this happen? So parachain auctions will be done one at a time, but it's looking like these will be about every 2 weeks. So in the Polkadot and Kusama ecosystem, these things will be happening on an ongoing basis for the foreseeable future. So crowd loans. Crowd loans, first of all, like I said, are used for the opening bid in an auction. So teams will crowdsource these tokens and then use them in that parachain auction at the next step. If you're a user and you contribute KSM to a Kusama parachain, or if you contribute DOT to a Polkadot parachain, you're essentially agreeing to locking those tokens for the duration of that parachain slot. In the example that I used earlier, so let's assume 24 months. Then after 24 months, your original principal is returned back to you. So it's essentially no loss in a much more ethical model than we've seen in the past with things like ICOs. Because in this case, you really hold the team accountable for actually delivering on their vision, on their white paper, because they need to add value to their network because they're actually not raising any funds directly from you as the community member. And then last, I kind of hinted at this just now, but the funds that are contributed in KSM or in DOT are never touched by the team. So there's no worries about teams raising money and running away with it, not delivering on what they promised. All the interests are really aligned here and the team is really held accountable. In the crowd loan, this is the crowd loan period. This is kind of what it looks like. You've got multiple teams crowdsourcing KSM or DOT from their communities, and that leads into the parachain slot auction. So that everything that was raised in that crowd loan stage is Not accessible to the team, but they can actually use that in their parachain slot auction. So you can think of it like a poker table. At the beginning of the auction, all these teams will basically go all in with the funds that they raised in their crowd loan. And then how do we determine the winner? When the auction starts, we will know the open time here in the green, and we will know the close time in the orange over here. And the most exciting point will be when we hit this close time, the Kusama or Polkadot relay chain itself will randomly select a time that determines the end time, this red bar here. So in this example, you've got Parachain B bidding, Parachain C bidding, Parachain A bid, E and F beat A in terms of number of KSM, but the winner was determined at this red line. So the highest bidder was Parachain A. This is called an unpermissioned candle auction, and it incentivizes teams to bid as high as they can, as early as they can, instead of waiting till the end like you might have seen on eBay, where teams or where people try to snipe at the end and get the highest bid. This is a full walkthrough then of this whole process. So you've got users over here contributing KSM. They contribute, in this example, to Karura, 500,000 KSM. Karura wins the first slot on Kusama and then begins its launch process. So all of the KSM that was crowdsourced in this original crowd loan period is then locked in the core Kusama relay chain. And then KAR is then distributed, the native token of Karura, KAR, is distributed to the crowd loan contributors. And then at the same time, Karura is also launching. So the Karura stablecoin, the liquid KSM staking, as well as the Karura AMM DEX, the Karura DEX, all go live on top of Karura when this happens. And then at the end of the parachain slot, all the KSM is returned to the supporters. Now, what's the last question that people sometimes have is what happens at the end of that slot? So in this example, let's say that it was a one-year parachain slot. The KSM is returned to the original crowd loan supporters, and then there's three options for any team to kind of maintain their access to the relay chain. First is to host another crowd loan and do another parachain auction. Second is to self-fund. So Karura and Akala will both have a decentralized sovereign wealth fund, and over time that will continue to build and build so that we can become sovereign and self-sustainable and actually bid with our own treasury, our own sovereign wealth fund, for future slots. And then the third option, there's probably several wiki articles and videos that you could watch about this, but the other option is to become a parathread, which just means that you have a little bit less frequent access to the relay chain itself. So that's it in about 8 minutes. Hopefully you learned something. Let me know if you have any questions. Thank you. Bye.